King's Journal, 13th day of September, in the year of our Lord, 1451. Today I read from Proverbs 27, "As iron sharpens iron, so one man sharpens another." It makes me wonder how Sir Gavin is getting along with Richard and Robert, and whether he's been able to teach them anything. I have always had great confidence in him, but my sons have had little interest in anything but their own happiness.
There's no surprise stuff. It's a piece of cake.
Oh, really?
Look! Okay. Where?
Take that! And that! And that!
Hey, that's not fair. You're gonna say that in a real battle? It'll never be in a real battle. Princes have knights are fighting battles for them.
Oh, they do it, eh?
Oh, Sir Gavin. You scared me.
Yeah,
don't think up on us like that.
So you think you'll never be in a real battle, huh?
Bet we won't. Will we?
Well, you guys still think life is fun and games and just taking it easy all the time.
Hey, I ate my vegetables last night. That wasn't easy.
Now listen to me. If you're ever in a real battle with swords, I don't know. But there's a battle going on that I've been trying to tell you about. And we need to fight every day.
What are you talking about? I don't see any real battle.
Well, they're not always visible, but make no mistake, they're real. There's a battle between light and dark, good and evil, between truth and error.
Oh, so you mean like spiritual battles?
Yes, that's right. That's why God has given us a special armor to wear, an armor that is more important than swords and shields.
Armor? Like what?
Well, like the belt of truth, where we stand by the uncompromising, absolute truth of God's Word, and the breastplate of righteousness, where we strive to do what's right in God's sight. As believers, we are to put these things on every day, just like a suit of armor. And there are other pieces, too.
Really?
Yes, but we'll talk about those later. Robert, contrary to your opinion, sword fighting is not easy. It takes a lot of work.
Yeah, but then I look good up there.
Well, you know my real opinion?
Give it to him, Gavin.
Well, you see, you picked up your feet instead of sliding them. You crossed your legs at least 10 times. Your breathing was all wrong. Your balance was terrible. And you concentrated more on your opponent than you did on your surroundings. But other than that, you did great.
Is it really that bad?
Well, let's just say you both have a lot of work to do.
Your luncheon is ready, boys. Sir Gavin, you're welcome to stay if you like. We have plenty.
Oh, thank you, Ivan, but not today.
Suit yourself. Probably doesn't like our cooking.
Okay, Richard and Robert, think about what I've said. And go ahead and keep practicing, and I'll see you tomorrow.
I'll see ya. Bye. Man, my stars. Sword fighting really builds up an appetite.
Lie down for a while. I feel a headache coming on. hope it's not the plague.
You think she'll be all right? Come on, it's Ida. She gets a headache and she thinks it's the plague. She gets a hangnail and thinks it's leprosy. Of course she'll be okay. Are you going to read the card? Oh, yeah, almost forgot. Dear Prince Richard and Prince Robert, thank you for apologizing for all the mean and nasty things you have done to me since the first day I started at King's Manor. I just want you to know that I forgive both of you. See, no hard feelings, what a great guy. And because you have stopped mistreating me, I'm going to stop spitting in your soup. Yours truly, Brom the Cook. I'm not hungry anymore.
Exactly as you're told, we'll get along just fine.
Yes, my lady.